Bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh, my soul. Worship his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh, my soul. I worship your holy name. The sun comes up. It's a new day dawning. It's time to sing your song again. Whatever may pass and whatever lies before me, let me be singing when the evening comes. Bless the your holy name. You're rich in love and you're slow to anger. Your name is great and your heart is kind. For all your goodness I will keep on saying. 10,000 reasons for my heart to find. So bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul. Worship his holy name. Worship your holy name. Bless you, Lord. And on that day when my strength is failing, the end draws near and my time has come, still my soul will sing your praise unending. 10,000 years and then his holy name. Sing like never before. Oh my soul, I worship your holy name. Come bless the Lord, oh my soul. Oh my soul, worship his holy name. Yes, I will worship your holy name. Lord, I worship your holy name. Sing like never. Worship your holy name, Jesus.
Amen. Hallelujah. Yes, Father, we worship your holy name, Lord, for another beautiful day, another morning, another beginning of the week. Father, Lord, we bless your name. Great and reliable God, we thank you. Our great and mighty God, our dependable God, our omnipotent God, we praise you, Lord. We worship your holy name. We thank you, Lord, for your wisdom and for your power. For you are God, and there's no other God beside you. Oh, Father, Lord, you are the Jehovah, the one who does wondrous things. We thank you, Lord, for all the spiritual blessings in heavenly places in Christ Jesus, for which you have blessed us with. We thank you for another day, another week, oh Lord. We bless your name. We worship you, Lord, for yours is the greatness, the power, and the glory, and the victory, and the majesty. You are worthy, O Lord, worthy to be praised, worthy to be honored this morning. We give you our praise. We give you our honor, Lord. With humble hearts, Lord, we come before you this morning and we say thank you, Lord. Thank you, mighty Father. Holy Spirit divine, we thank you for you are our helper. Thank you for your work in us, leading us into all truth. Let your light shine in us this day. Let your light shine in our household this day. Let your light shine in our community this day. We worship you. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. Lord, let your spirit come upon us afresh this morning. Lord, our God, we read it in 1 Samuel 10:10, that when they came to the hill there, behold, a group of prophets met him, and the Spirit of God came upon him mightily, so that he prophesied among them. Lord our God, you are the Spirit of the living God. In you we put our hope and trust. Because of you, we are able to experience the fullness of God in our life. Freedom comes as you reign in our life. You guide and you direct our thoughts. You pray for us, Holy Spirit, with words that we don't even know we need to pray. You are the Spirit of God. You are his helper. You are his mighty breath. We lift you up this morning. We honor you. May your fullness be known to this world which needs you so desperately. Spirit of God, forgive us for the sins we harbor in our hearts. Because the word of God says, if I have any sin in my heart, the Lord will not hear me. Forgive us for any sin that we harbor in our heart. Any sin that will hinder us this morning, forgive us. Forgive us for envy. Forgive us when we look at other people's life that appear to be so picture perfect that we begin to become ungrateful for all that you have done for us. Forgive us. Forgive us when we are jealous, comparing our paths for us with the favor and grace you have given to others on their part. That only causes distance between us and you, and we need to be close to you. We confess these sins to you and ask you to keep us from them in the future. We surrender ourselves to you this morning, Holy Spirit. Come and take control. Thank you for your kindness and your faithfulness. Thank you for living in us. Thank you for imparting the wisdom of your word to our hearts. Thank you for all of this and even more. Thank you for being with us even when we feel so alone. We may even wonder who cares sometimes, but we know that you are there, Spirit of the living God, and you are near. We bless your name this morning and lift up your holiness to be praised as we ask you to be ever present in our spirits. May your Holy Spirit dominate our own. We don't want to wrestle anymore with fear, with pain, or doubt. We want the trust and rest that come from your presence to be evident in all that we do and feel. We seek you, Spirit of the living God. We seek your closeness to us. We need your presence in all that we do. As we begin a new week, Lord, today, in each day, in each moment, help us know that you love to know you and to love you as we ought to. Help us, Lord. Help us, blessed Holy Spirit. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, Lord God Almighty, Spirit of counsel, Spirit of wisdom and comfort. Thank you as you take your place in our life, in our family, in our neighborhood, in our community this day. Blessed be to your name. Hallelujah be to your name. Amen. This is the day that the Lord has made. So let us declare that, Lord, you command the morning and you cause the day spring to know its place. Let all wickedness be shaken out of my life today, Father God. Let all wickedness be shaken out of my children's life. Let all wickedness be shaken out of my family, of my neighborhood today, Father Lord, because your words say you command the morning and you cause the day spring to know its place. So, Lord, let all wickedness be shaken out of my life today. Let all wickedness be shaken out of my children's life, of my family today, Lord, in the name of Jesus. Let us pray that, Lord, let the morning and the day spring arise in my life. Let the morning and the day spring arise in my life, arise in the life of my children, in the life of my grandchildren, every member of my loved one, my brothers, my sisters. Lord, this morning, let the morning and the day spring arise in our life, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, gracious Lord, let the dew of the morning be upon my life. In the name of Jesus Christ, let the dew of the morning be upon my life, be upon my children's life. Father God, I lift up my voice unto you this morning and I ask, oh Lord, let the dew of the morning be upon my life, upon my children's life. In the name of Jesus Christ, let us ask the Lord this morning that, Father, let the blessing of the morning arise in my life, because your word says that every day you load us with blessing. So, Father God, let the blessing of the morning arise in my life, arise in the life of my children, in my household this morning, Father. Let the blessing of the morning arise in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, gracious Lord, let the sun of righteousness arise with healing in his wing, and let every area of my life be healed in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, gracious Lord, this morning, let the sun of righteousness arise with healing in his wings, and let every area of my life be healed in the mighty name of Jesus. Our Lord and our God, this morning is a brand new day. Lord, you promised that the sun will not smite us by day nor the moon by night. We commit this day into your hand, O Lord God Almighty. Ask the Lord that, Father God, teach me to follow in your footstep in the name of Jesus Christ. Teach me, Lord, to follow in your footstep in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, teach my children, Lord, Father, to follow in your footstep. In the mighty name of Jesus, as we begin this new week, O Lord, teach us, Father, to follow in your footsteps. Father God, your word says that the step of the righteous are ordered by the Lord. Order our footsteps, Lord, this week. Let us be in the right place at the right time. Oh, Father God, we commit our children before you, God, that you order their footsteps, O Lord. That they will be in the right place at the right time, in the mighty name of Jesus. Heavenly Father, we are asking you, Lord, this morning, order our footsteps. Guide us into the path of righteousness for your name's sake, O Lord. Guide us, direct us, lead us. You are ever faithful, God. You never fail. You never change. You are the unchangeable God. So, Father, we are lifting our eyes unto you for this week, that you will guide us, O Lord. Father, Lord, we ask you, help us, Father, not to forget you. Help us, O Lord, to know that you are our God, that you are faithful. You never change. So, Father, take absolute control. We commit ourselves unto your hand, into your able hand, O Lord God Almighty. Arise and give us courage. courage to stand before your searching gaze, Lord. Give us courage this morning. Keep us from hiding our light under the load of anxiety. We bring our burden, our cares before you, Lord, this morning, because you say, come unto me, all you that are heavy laden, cast all your cares upon me. Lord, that is in obedience to your word we have come this morning, casting our cares upon you, because you are the only one that is able, Lord God Almighty, to lift the burden. So, Father, this morning, will there be anything in our life that will not allow this burden to be removed? We ask in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, that gracious Lord, you will remove it in the name of Jesus. Remove it for our life. Forgive us of our narrow vision. Forgive us, Lord, of our weak commitment. Forgive us, Father God, of our careless worship and self-centered attitude. We surrender ourselves to you, Lord. This is a new beginning of another week. Lord, we are asking you, Lord, that you will set us in the right paths, O Lord God Almighty. Father, we are asking you, empower us to hear your voice and to discern your will. Empower us, O Lord, to hear your voice. You say, my sheep hear my voice. The voice of stranger, they will not hear. So, Father God, this morning we ask, O Lord, our Father, help us, O Lord, to hear your voice, to hear your voice. Do not make us to hear any strange voice. Lord, we lift our children before you, Lord. Help them. Help them to hear your voice this morning. Make your path. They are passed straight, O Lord. Every crooked way, Lord, make it straight before them and before us this morning. We are standing as a priest, O Lord, for our family this morning. And we bring them to you, Lord. We bring them to you. We lift them up to you. We are asking you, Lord, that you have your way in the life of our family, in the life of our children, particularly this morning. Let your light shine upon them. Let your light shine upon us, O Lord, this morning. You are the author and the finisher of our faith. Help us, Father God. We need your help. This is a new week. We have not journeyed this pathway before. Lord, the strength that we need, the wisdom that we need, the courage that we need, everything that we need, Father God, that you will supply them according to your riches in glory by Christ Jesus. Thank you, our eternal Rock of Ages. Thank you, Father God. Thank you, Father, for everything, for all the things that you are doing in our life. For all that we do this week, O Lord, oh Father, we thank you. With a great expectation, we're entering into this week, O Lord. Our hope is set on you that you will not fail. All your promises, Father, it will not fail, because all your words are there, yea and amen. Father, we bless your name this morning. Thank you, our Lord and our God. Hallelujah be to your name. We worship you. We adore you, Father. In the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. This morning, let us go back again to Hebrews that we'll be looking at, Hebrews chapter 11, and see this morning. I say, any one of us in our life, we have been stuck between a rock and a hard place. What do you do? What do you do? What should I do if I encounter this week? I find myself between a rock and a hard place. I say, better to obey God than man. So in the life of Moses, it's Moses we're looking at this morning. We're just going to look at just one verse of it. Hebrews 11:23. Again, he said, by faith, Moses' parents hid him for 3 months after he was born, because they saw he was no ordinary child, and they were not afraid of the king's edict. By faith, when he was born, was hidden 3 months by his parents, because they saw he was a beautiful child, He was a handsome child. He was not just ordinary child. Parents, how do you behold your child, your children? What do you see in them? Do you see their beauty, the handsomeness of that son, the beauty of that daughter? Do you see? What do you see? Moses' parents saw something different in that child. And as a result, they dare the consequence that this child, no matter what they are doing, I'm going to defy the order of the king. So you see, if you were reading, you'll be following. The party eventually came to an end for the Israelites in Egypt. The Pharaoh, who knew Joseph and his brothers, had died. We know, even in our place of work, when there's change of administration, things doesn't go the same way. Everybody wants to set their own rules. They want to prove that they are the boss. They are the one in charge. So things will change. Life may have been easy for you before, but after sometimes you see that you don't have your way anymore. So that was the experience of Moses' parents and all the Israelites in Egypt. Because Pharaoh couldn't manage the relationship. They saw the immigrants as threats and began to make laws to impede their growth and progress. Those of us in diaspora, in any country you may be, as a foreigner, you can experience a little bit of this in one way or the other. From higher tax law to hard labor, they did all manner of things to stop them from expanding. And you know what? They eventually passed a birth control decree to regulate their growth. The decree was to kill Israelite boy babies. I want to ask us, you, those of us in place of authority, in our place of work, what kind of thing are you participating in that is making hard for those under you? In any administrative that you find yourself, what is your contribution? Think about it, my brothers and my sister. Are you an employer? How are you making life easy for those working for you? Think about it. It was in this critical time that Moses was born. His parents faced a direct, horrible dilemma. To keep the baby would mean the death penalty from Pharaoh. To keep the baby means disobeying God. As we will say today, they seem to be between the devil and the deep blue sea. They are stuck between a rock and a hard place. What should they do? They thought and they pray and eventually choose to defy the orders of man and obey God. You can read that in Exodus chapter 2. They didn't know at that time precisely what would happen. But they knew that it was more important, more imperative for them to obey God than to live in fear of men. Their choice to obey God than fear the order of the oppressor eventually paid off. Through miraculous intervention, the boy Moses survived. In life, my brothers and my sister, we will always be faced with choices to please men or to please God. As we go this week, we are going to encounter it. If we choose to please men, we may enjoy temporarily. We may have some gratification or some peace and promotion. However, take note, it will eventually lead to a bitter end. But when we choose to please God, it may result in temporary affliction or suffering. We may lose friends and opportunities and be termed stupid. They can call you any kinds of name. But God will eventually intervene and make ways where there seems to be no way. So this morning, I want to encourage us that the Lord will help us to make the righteous. But take the word of God. See what God is saying. Proverbs 29:25 say, fearing people is a dangerous trap, but trusting the Lord means safety. Proverbs 29:25. And Isaiah 51, verse 12 to 13 said, I am he who comforts you. Who are you that you should be afraid of a man who will die, and the son of man who will be made like grass? And you forget the Lord your maker, who stretched out the heavens and laid the foundation of the earth. You are feared continually every day because of the fury of the oppressor. And when he has prepared to destroy, and where is the fury of the oppressor? And like the psalmist says, Psalm 27 verse 1, the Lord is my light and my salvation. Who shall I fear? The Lord is the strength of my life. Of whom shall I be afraid? And Jesus Christ said, do not fear those who kill the body, but cannot kill the soul, but rather fear him who is able to destroy both soul and body in hell. So my dear brothers and my sister, just like Paul asked us in Romans 8:31, what then shall we say to these things? If God is for us, who can be against us? So determine in your mind, by the grace of God, that as we go, as we start this new week, that you'll be able to answer, that the apostle answered in Acts chapter 4, verse 19. He said, but Peter and John answered and said, whether it is right in the sight of God to listen to you more than to God, you judge. But today, Father, we're asking you for grace, because we know we cannot do this on our own. Oh, Lord, our God, we ask for grace to make choices that please you when we are faced with choosing between you and men. Pray this morning. Pray for yourself. Pray for your family. That, Father God, this week, as we begin this week, Lord, we ask for your grace to make choices that please you. When we are faced with choosing between you and men, help us, Father. Help us this morning. We ask for your grace, O Lord. Grace to make the right choice. Father, Lord, we ask for your grace for our children, Lord. To make choices, O Lord, that pleases you. Choices, Lord, help us. Help them to make the right choice. Ask the Lord that, Lord, embody me to always speak the truth in love and wisdom. When I'm faced with truth and falsehood, Lord, help me, Lord. Help me, embody me to always speak the truth in love and wisdom. When I'm faced with truth and falsehood, ask the Lord this morning. That, Father, in times when I have denied you out of fear of men, forgive me. Oh, gracious Lord, forgive me, Lord, for the times I've denied you out of fear of men. Forgive me. And from this day, Lord, uproot out of my heart every atom of fear of men. Oh, Lord, and fill me with your fear only in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord, this morning, uproot. Lord, some of us have made some decision. We have taken some action. We have done some things because of fear of men. But Father, Lord, in your mercy this morning, forgive us and uproot from our hearts every atom of fear of men and fill us with your fear only, Lord. Fill us with your fear only. And for those of us who are parents, help us, Father God. Help us, Father God, to see the beauty that Moses' parents saw that made them to defy the order of the land. Lord, help us to see the beauty that you have put in our children, Father God, to go to any length that we can go possible by your grace and power for them, oh Lord, to preserve, to uphold. Father, Lord, give us the strength, Lord. Every parent on this prayer platform this morning, oh Lord, our Father, uphold us by your mighty hand, oh Lord. Give us the strength, the courage, the wisdom that we need, Father God. Help us this morning. Help us, Father, help us this morning. We need your help, Lord. We need your help. Help us this morning. Father God, help us. We need your help for our children this morning. Help us, Father. Help us this morning, Father God. Help us, Father. This morning, because of what they did, the Lord was able to visit them. Divine visitation, divine intervention. I want us to pray this morning. The divine angels of my children. Divine angel of my children, visit them. Take up your respective assignments in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray for our children this morning. That Father God, let divine angel of our children visit them and take up your respective assignments in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. This morning, Father, let our children receive angelic visitation. Like Zechariah, for a turnaround breakthrough that will disgrace in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Pray for our children this morning. That mighty God, mighty Father, I leave this my son before you. I leave my daughter before you. Lord, I'm asking you, Lord God Almighty, let these children receive angelic visitation like Zechariah for a turnaround breakthrough that will disgrace in their life in the name of Jesus Christ. Anything, oh Lord, that is causing disgrace among their peers this morning, Father, divine visitation, divine intervention this morning, Lord, let it come upon them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, our Father, let your divine visitation come upon our children this morning in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, you are ever faithful. Visit our children. Visit them, Lord. Visit them this morning. Because we, Lord, this is what happened. Yes, we can see how you are working. When you are about to visit the children of Israel, you started walking on the ground through the parents of Moses, oh Lord. Oh, mighty Father. You know how many years it took? It took 40 years. 40 years for Moses to go to the wilderness. 40 years, another 40 years. And he was 80. Hey Lord, you are marvelous. You are marvelous. So Father God, let our children receive divine visitation. Begin to walk, begin to do the underground work, behind the scene work, Lord. Begin in the life of our children. Begin to do it, Lord, this morning. Let our children receive visitation like Hannah, like Sarah, and like Elizabeth. And let their season of fruitfulness begin now, Lord. Let their season of fruitfulness begin in any area of their life, whether marital or academic or professional. Lord God Almighty, we lift our children before you this morning. And Lord, we're asking them that they will receive divine visitation like you visited Anna, you visited Sarah, you visited Elizabeth. Lord, some of these children, oh Lord, that are looking up to you. Some of them, Father, you know, they have to marry before they can have that blessing of the womb. So, Father, begin the behind-the-scenes work. Oh, Lord, begin as you did, oh, Lord God Almighty. Father, visit our children in the land of their affliction. Turn their mourning to dancing. Put laughter in their mouths. Oh Lord, put joy in their hearts, oh Lord God Almighty, and remove their reproach. Remove their reproach, Father God. Remove the reproach in the life of our children. Remove it, Father, by your power. Oh Lord, our God, remove their reproach in the name of Jesus Christ. Father in heaven, we are asking for divine visitation this morning. And we know that you are the only one that is able, Lord, to visit them. So, Lord, this morning we're asking you, Lord, that you will visit every dry region in the lives of our children with early and latter rain, that we produce harvest of good things for them in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, our Father, this way, the beginning of this week, we're lifting our children before you. We're asking you, Lord, that we visit every dry region in the lives of our children with early and latter rain, that we produce harvest of good things in their life. Oh Lord, let it produce harvest of good things in the life of our children. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Our Father and our God, we're asking you, deliver this our children from all powers oppressing them. All powers that is suppressing them. All powers that is intimidating their life. And Lord, deliver them and visit the camp of the enemy with your fury, with your snares. Visit the camp of the enemy that is oppressing, that is suppressing, that is intimidating the lives of our children. Visit the camp of that enemy with your fury and with your snare in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Father, we're asking you this morning that you will visit our children with the power to manifest, with the power to excel and become advertisement of your power as they move higher like eagle, Lord. This morning, we're standing as parents, Father God. Yes, we do not have to hide our children from the audit of Pharaoh, but we know that the spirit of Pharaoh is still reigning. So whatever we need to do as parents, Father, give us the grace. Give us the boldness. Whatever come upon the parents of Moses that made them to defy the order in order to save, don't just the life of Moses, because we can see they save generations. Oh, Father God, help us as parents this morning. Empower us. And visit our children, Lord, with the power to manifest, the power to excel, the power to become advertisement of your power, that you will demonstrate your power in their life in the name of Jesus Christ. Heavenly Father, gracious Lord, we ask, let the heavens of our children open for divine visitation, that we make people to celebrate and jubilate with them in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, our Father, this morning, let the heavens of our children open for divine visitation, that we make people to celebrate and jubilate with them in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Ah, gracious Lord. Father God, Lord Jesus, you know, we read it. You visited the pool of Bethesda. That man has been sitting there for many years. So, Lord, after the order of the man at the pool of Bethesda, Lord, give our children special visitation that will disgrace every long-standing problems in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. They've been counting years. They've been counting years, years, oh, Lord, that they've been having this problem, whatever be the problem. Lord, our God, in your majesty, in your power, Lord, this morning, Father, in the name of Jesus, we're asking you, Lord, give them a special visitation. I offer the order of the man at the pool of Bethesda, that, Lord, you will visit them. You will disgrace every long-standing problem in their lives in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, this week we are asking you, Lord. You say we should ask anything in your name, and that you will give it. Lord Jesus, we're asking the Father in your name this morning. We're asking that our children, that you will visit our children for supernatural surprises. That you will give them supernatural surprises and do the unbelievable, the humanly impossible to advertise your glory in their life. Oh Lord, our God. You are the only one that can do it. So, Father, we pray this morning. We pray, Lord, for our children this morning. Give our children visitation or supernatural surprises and do the unbelievable and the humanly impossible to advertise your glory in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, in the name of Jesus Christ, Peter was put in prison, but the angel visited him and set him free from the prison. Lord, our God, this morning, let our children receive angelic visitation that will set them free from every satanic prison holding them in bondage, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, Father God, is there any child? Is there any child this morning that is being held captive in the camp of the enemy? Lord, our God, we lift our voice unto you this morning, and we're asking you, Father God, that you will set their mind free. You will set them free, oh Lord, our God, in any area, in any form that our children has been held captive this morning. Oh, gracious Father God, just after the order of the Apostle Peter, let our children receive angelic visitation that will set them free from every satanic prison holding them in bondage, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. You are the God that changed times and seasons, oh Father. You are the God that changed time and season. Let our children receive divine restoration and turn again their captivity. Turn again their captivity, Lord God Almighty. Turn again their captivity in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we are asking you this year, in this year, Lord, give our children divine visitation that will make take them out of the crowd in the family line. In the name of Jesus Christ, in their father's house, Lord, this year, Lord God Almighty, we lift our voice unto you. Give our children divine visitation that will take them out of the crowd in the family line, in the name of Jesus Christ. Father, we dedicate these children once again to you. You have given them to us. We are caretakers. And we say, Lord, we cannot do anything on our own. We surrender them to you, Lord, this morning. The life of our children are available for you, Lord. Wherever they are, Lord, it doesn't matter this morning. Let them experience your divine visitation. Let them experience your divine visitation this morning. As you turn the situation of Jabesh around, Father, give our children divine visitation, that you remove barrier of darkness and release their key of breakthrough in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, you will change their story, Father. We are asking you this morning, change their story. Change their story. Father, Lord, I know. Father, you know, as parents, the pain that we're going through. But Father God, this morning, there's a balm in Gilead. Apply the balm of Gilead to our pain, Lord, as parents, for our children this morning. Lord God Almighty, let every wicked power of the Father's house that is behind the suffering, that is behind anything that is not of God in the life of our children, angel of the living God, feed them with the bread of adversity and water of affliction in the name of Jesus Christ. Any power of the Father's house that is behind the suffering or the any mishap in the life of our children, this morning, angel of the living God, feed them with bread of adversity and water of affliction in the name of Jesus Christ. Our Lord and our God, we pray this morning that every witchcraft barrier of good things in the life of our children be liberated by the resurrection power of the blood of Jesus Christ. Be liberated and come alive this morning. Every witchcraft barrier of good things, whether it's marriage, whether it's career, whatever it is, that witchcraft power has buried this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ, be liberated by the resurrection power of the Lord Jesus Christ. And the power and the blood of Jesus Christ, come alive. Come alive this morning. Come alive this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh Lord, revive your grace, your mercy, and your favor in the lives of our children, that we make their case uncommon story in this generation. Is there anything too hard for you, Father? There is nothing too hard for you. That is why, Lord, we're lifting our children before you this morning. That, Father God, you are the God of grace. Revive your grace, your mercy, and your favor in the lives of our children, that we make their case uncommon story in this generation. Oh, Lord, our Father, revive it. Revive it, oh Lord. Every embargo that is placed upon the lives of our children, be lifted in the name of Jesus Christ. Every embargo that is put upon the life of our children, in the name of Jesus Christ, be lifted, be lifted, be lifted, be lifted, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Let it be lifted this morning, in the name of Jesus Christ. Ah, gracious Lord, as roots, the Moabites receive divine visitation and become the grandmother of our Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, this morning, visit our children, no matter their background. No matter their background, visit them. Use them for your glory. Use them for your glory, Lord. Use our children for your glory. In the mighty name of Jesus Christ. And Father, arise. You are the mighty man of war. You are the captain of the army. This morning, Father God, arise and fight all the battles. All the battles, Father. Fight for them this morning, Lord. Oh, gracious Father, fight for our children this morning. Fight for them, mighty God. Fight for our children. You are the God Almighty. Fight for them. Fight for them. Lord God Almighty, thank you for your word. Thank you, Lord. Your word says in Psalm 89, verse 36, that his seed shall endure forever and his throne as the sun before me. Let us pray this morning that my Father, make my seeds, some of us have more than one, make my seed to endure forever and let my throne shine as the sun according to your word. Remember, we start praying Psalm 89 yesterday. We'll continue this morning. That Father God, this day, Lord, according to your word in Psalm 89 verse 36, said his seed shall endure forever and his throne as the sun before me. So Lord, make my seed to endure forever and let my throne shine as the sun in the name of Jesus Christ. Ask the Lord this morning that, Father, cast me not off, break not my edges, and don't bring down my stronghold in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, mighty Father, cast me not off, Lord. Break not my edges, and don't bring down my strongholds in the name of Jesus Christ. Help, Lord. Help, Lord. Your words say, because they disobey you, thou hast set up the right hand of his adversary. Thou hast made his enemies to rejoice. I pray this morning that, my Lord, my Father, by your grace, O Lord, do not allow the hands of the enemy to prevail against me. O Lord, mighty Father, I pray this morning, do not allow the hand of the enemy prevail against me, prevail against my family, in the name of Jesus Christ. Do not let an enemy rejoice over me. Oh Lord, mighty God, this morning, I pray thee, Father God, do not let the enemies rejoice over me, over my children. Intervene, oh Lord God Almighty, in my life. Intervene in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. It's a prayer this morning that, Father, don't render my weapons of battle useless in my hands, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, mighty Father, don't render my weapons of battle useless in my hands. Let me not fall in battle, in the name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, mighty Father, let me not fall in battle, in the name of Jesus Christ. Because your word said, thou hast also turned the edge of his sword and hast not made him to stand in the battle. Pray this morning that whatever is in my life that will not make me to stand in battle, Father, I pray that you will remove it in the name of Jesus Christ. We know that life is a battle. Life is spiritual and it's a battle. Pray this morning in my household, Father God, don't render our weapons of battle useless. We have the weapon of prayer, the weapon of the word of God. Do not render it useless, O Lord God Almighty. Do not let me fall in battle. Do not let any member of my household fall in battle, in the name of Jesus Christ. Let us pray this morning. Because that verse 44 of Psalm 89 says, thou hast made his glory to cease and cast his throne down to the ground. Ask the Lord this morning that, Father, protect my glory from being tampered with. Protect my children's glory from being tampered with, O Lord God Almighty. Oh, yes, Father God, protect our glory from being tampered with, in the name of Jesus Christ. Protect our children from being glory from being tampered with, in the name of Jesus Christ. Cast not our glory down to the ground, O Lord, in the name of Jesus Christ. In the mighty name of Jesus. Verse 45 said, the days of his youth hast thou shortened. Thou hast covered him with shame. Pray this morning that, Father, I've come to you this morning in the name of Jesus. Satisfy me with long life. Oh, Lord, mighty Father, satisfy me with long life. Satisfy my children with long life in the name of Jesus Christ. And replace my shame with your glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Lord, mighty Father, replace my shame with your glory in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Oh, Father God, we thank you this morning. Our Lord and our God, we honor you this morning. We adore you, Father. We say hallelujah be to your name. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord God Almighty. Hallelujah. Let us pray for our worship service this morning in the various places where the children of God will gather together. Let us ask for divine visitation this morning. That, Lord, as your people gather together today, O Lord, to worship, we're asking you, Lord, visit us. Visit us, O Lord. There are some, oh Lord, that today they have to go underground. But some of us, we dress in our best thing, Lord, today, and go and worship. Help us to worship in truth, oh Lord God Almighty. To worship you in truth, Father God. That, Lord, you will speak to our heart, oh Lord, that our worship will not be in vain, but that we encounter you, Lord God Almighty. Help us, Lord, to encounter you, Lord, today, in the mighty name of Jesus Christ. Visit us. Visit your church, oh Lord, this morning. As your word go out, oh Lord, let it go out with power and with authority, Father God. So that it will not return to you void, it will accomplish the purpose for which you said it in the name of Jesus Christ. Father God, let your word be like fire in the mouth of the speaker, Lord God Almighty, this morning. As people come together to worship, to praise you, they have come into your presence. Lord, spread the table before us. We have come to dine before you this day, Lord God Almighty. Spread the table before us. In the presence of our enemies, Lord. Anoint us with the oil of gladness, O Lord, this morning. As your church, Father God, that you will revive your church. Revive your church, O Lord, our God. Revive us. Revive your church this morning. Thank you for your mercy. Thank you for your love. Thank you for your kindness. We pray, Father God, for our leaders this morning. We lift them up before you. Give them wisdom. Give them wisdom, O Lord. Empower them, Father, to demonstrate sincere love for all men. Empower them. Empower them, Lord. Give our leaders the vision to lead in fear of you and in the awe of you. Help them, mighty Father God. This morning, show forth your power. Lord our God, visit our temple this morning. Yes, we know that our body is the temple of the Holy Spirit. But Lord, there's a place that we will meet together this morning. Father, Lord, visit it as you visit the temple in your days when you are here on earth. You visited the temple and you look around and you saw those things that need to be chased out. So, Father God, this morning, even in our physical temple, in which we call church that we're going to this morning, make a divine visitation. Look around and see all the tables that they have set up and that need to be overturned, that you will overturn it in the name of Jesus Christ. Lord God Almighty, every table of money changer, every table of virtue changer, every table of potential changer that they have set in the church, that they are buying and selling instead of worshiping you, Father God, turn it upside down this morning. And those that need to be chased out, take your whip and chase them out. Chase them out this morning. Any power that wants to interfere with our fellowship this morning, as we come before you, Lord God Almighty, in all these various locations, various churches, we're asking you, Father God, that we chase them out in the name of Jesus Christ. Let your power come into our midst. Manifest your glory, Lord. Thank you, mighty Father. Thank you, blessed Lord, for this new week. We worship you. For all the goodness that you have in store for us, we bless your name. Hallelujah be to your name. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. And the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us now and forevermore. Amen. Amen. Good morning, everyone. The Lord bless you. The Lord keep you. If you have the time, stay behind and let us do our exercise.